Both black bear and grizzly bear are found in the North Cascade ecosystem. Current research indicates that few grizzly bears remain in the ecosystem, while black bear populations appear to remain strong. Let's take a look at what makes a bear a grizzly bear.
Grizzly bears in this kind of ecosystem that are largely eating vegetation don't get that big. They don't get as huge as these bears we see on the coast of Alaska, where they eat a lot of salmon. Here, they eat a lot of plants. And so they don't get much taller than about 8 feet if they're standing up, which is quite tall. And weight-wise, between 250 and 600 pounds. A big male would be probably 600 pounds. They put all their calories on with huckleberries in the fall. And so looking at 20,000 plus calories a day just on berries does not make for a giant bear. So sometimes it's hard to tell black bears and grizzly bears apart. Grizzly bears have what we call the grizzled fur, these sort of bicolored fur, as opposed to black bears that are usually black. But both bears can be black or blonde or cinnamon colored or brown. There's a big variation in color. And grizzly bears are often have the distinctive shoulder hump, but we've also seen some black bears in this system that have kind of a pronounced shoulder hump. Those muscles go with the digging power. And so you have to look at grizzly bears and black bears kind of side by side in the pictures to tell them apart. When we look at a grizzly bear, the first thing we see are the big teeth, because we notice that as a sign of danger. But the truth is, grizzly bears are omnivores. They eat a lot of vegetation. They eat a lot of huckleberries, starchy roots like pea vine and vetch. And if you look at teeth of a carnivore, you can see the really sharp carnassial where the molars come together to tear flesh. But if you look at a grizzly bear, what you see are these butodont teeth, these really flat teeth that are made for grinding, just for grinding vegetation. So in this ecosystem, in the spring, they look for pea vines and vetches and things with starchy roots that they can dig up with their sharp claws. They'll turn over the soil and they'll dig for those vines. And so they like that disturbed soil area. They find those vines every year in the same spots. And grizzly bears have long, sharp claws and big, powerful shoulder muscles. And so they dig to turn the ground over to get to those roots and tubers. And then as the berries ripen, they spend a lot of their time on huckleberries. And so that's what these teeth do, is grind, 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 and digest. But they also use these big canines to catch prey every now and then. They can catch moose calves and elk calves. They can also get carrion and steal food from other predators. There are many factors that affect grizzly bear populations. The number one thing that limits them are people. Their history with humans has been conflicted at best, and so when they disappear off the landscape, we look at ways to restore their populations in the framework of what can we do on the landscape. The first thing is habitat. They need big areas without roads, without a lot of people to establish themselves or to recover. The other big problem with grizzly bear recovery is that they have the slowest reproductive rate of any mammal in North America. They're tied with the muskox. They're very, very slow at replacing themselves. That one offspring that grows to an adult and reproduce again takes a very long time. And so recovery for grizzly bears is slow. In this ecosystem, where they've diminished to very, very few, it's unrecoverable naturally. They can't catch up to that curve to find each other, reproduce, survive, and increase the population. Grizzly bears have always been a part of this ecosystem. Their numbers have gotten very, very small for a variety of reasons, but it's our place now to provide the stewardship to help recover them. We don't know exactly what ecosystem functions grizzly bears might do in a measurable way. What we do know is that a biodiverse ecosystem is a resilient ecosystem. So by getting these bears back in the system, helping them recover, we're creating a more resilient ecosystem against change. The more species that are in their natural places that have always been here, the more ability this ecosystem has to deal with large fires and climate change, different snowpacks, all these things that affect the ecosystem that might affect species disproportionately. The grizzly bear is one more piece, a very important piece of that puzzle, to help the ecosystem rebound when things change.
With the restoration of grizzly bears, the North Cascades would be one of the few ecosystems left in the contiguous United States that has the full complement of carnivore species known to be native prior to European settlement. Such biodiversity can be an indication of a healthy ecosystem. Restoring a self-sustaining grizzly bear population would contribute to the restoration of biodiversity in the ecosystem for the benefit and enjoyment of present and future generations.